The Canopy Digital Parenting App inspects images, videos, websites in real time to eliminate explicit or blocked content before it reaches your child's device. Not only that, Canopy can even delete explicit images as they are taken on your child's device to prevent sexting before it even occurs, and allows you to set downtime schedules for your children's devices, whether they use iOS, Android, a Chromebook, Windows computer, or a Mac. It can filter and protect those devices. This video is going to show you exactly how Canopy works, what the different features of Canopy are, and how to install it on your children's devices. I would like to thank Canopy for sponsoring this review of their product and supporting my channel. Although the review is sponsored, all testing and opinions are my own. I do thoroughly test any product that I plan to endorse to make sure that I would use it before I even try to recommend it. After using Canopy for the last couple weeks, I can definitely say I recommend it. So let's get right into the review. Now, what's really unique about Canopy is that it uses AI to filter content within websites and applications. Now, this is very unique to this parental control app. It is not something I've seen in any other apps. In most parental control applications, you can either block or allow access to a site like YouTube, Instagram, even Amazon, but you can't filter the content within those applications. With Canopy, it automatically scans the website for inappropriate pictures and takes those pictures out of the running so they're not even displayed in real time. Another place where Canopy is different from other parental control apps is it is very focused on the inappropriate content, particularly pornography, sexting, or anything of that nature. Now, the claims on Canopy's website is that it can detect and block explicit content with 99.9% accuracy. I did put this to the test. I'll show you some examples. Don't worry, they'll be blurred out. But from the testing that I did, it does seem to be able to back up this claim. Now, the cost for Canopy is $7.99 a month for 3 devices, $9.99 a month if you want to protect 5 devices, or $15.99 a month if you want to protect 10 devices. You can also choose to pay annually for 5 devices to be covered, and that cost is $100 per year. Now, the devices that Canopy can control is iPhone, Android, PC, Mac computers, and Chromebooks. So you're not going to be able to protect any smart TVs or anything like that. Either way, Canopy is not able to filter content within websites like Netflix or Hulu. You would need to set up different profiles within those applications if you wanted to protect those. So on the smart TV, it doesn't really make sense anyway, but it does protect those main 5 devices, which are Android devices, iOS devices, so that's going to be iPhone and iPad, Mac computers, PC computers, so Windows computers, and Chromebooks. Now let's dig into some of these features so I can show you exactly how it works and what it does. The first one, again, the one that impressed me the most, is this smart filter. With this smart filter, you can still allow access to websites like TikTok, Discord, Instagram, YouTube, different websites. Even Google Images will be filtered out when you are using the Canopy software. So as you can see here, we're looking at these pictures on Google Images, and you're only seeing stuff that is deemed appropriate. It's going to filter out anything that is not. One of my favorite go-tos to find some inappropriate content. I like the artist, but she can post some inappropriate things. So if you go to Britney Spears' Instagram account, that was actually a really good way to test out this software. It's also going to help me when I am searching for anything that is inappropriate. If it's specifically inappropriate, it's just going to block the search altogether instead of going through to that. So it's really smart and uses artificial intelligence in order to help detect that. A lot of other filters will rely on reporting or some kind of database that lets it know that these are inappropriate websites. But what the Canopy software does is it uses artificial intelligence to understand what kind of content is in the page itself and then remove the content that is explicit. Now, apart from this smart filter, which I said super impressed me. I am really excited about that feature. I think it is really the next step in content filtering and works extremely well. But the next one that actually really impressed me is this sexting prevention. Now, again, with most parental control apps, it's going to be able to do more on an Android device than it can on an iOS device. Now, this is because of Apple's limitations on what third parties can do inside of the device itself. So if your child has an Android device, don't worry, you don't need to have an Android device in order to manage it properly. But if your child has an Android device, it's going to detect when an inappropriate image is taken. As you can see here, I relied on my favorite Britney Spears Instagram account and took a photo of an inappropriate picture on her account. Now, as you can see, when I took the picture, the Canopy app appeared asking if I want to send that picture to my parent to approve it or if I want to go ahead and just delete the photo. I really like this because it's basically taking it at the root. As soon as the inappropriate picture is detected is when it's going to kick into action and make sure that things are okay. It's not going to wait for that picture to be sent to somebody else because at that point it's too late. Other parental control apps might alert you to the fact that that picture has been taken, but it's not going to do anything about the picture. I love that this is going to either automatically delete it or ask you to send it to your parent for approval. Now, like I said, it does work differently for an iPhone. An iPhone is only going to detect it when the image is saved. So when you have an application like Snapchat or something like that, it's not detecting when the picture is taken. It's only detecting when the picture has been saved to the phone. So it's going to be a little bit later than it can on an Android. The other difference between the Android and the iPhone is the removal prevention. So for an Android device, if your child has an Android device, Canopy has some built-in settings that will require a parent's approval in order to remove the app. Now, with an iOS device, they can remove the app really easily. You will be notified that they have removed the app, so you can deal with it at that time. However, they do have a way to prevent the removal on an iOS device. It's a complicated 20-minute setup, so I'm not going to get into that in this video. I may do another video of just how to do that. I believe they have their own video that goes through that process, but they can walk you through that process and you can prevent the removal of Canopy on an iOS device. Now let's go through some of the settings that you can configure on the Canopy app from your parent's app. So the main setting is going to prevent sexting. So it's going to detect the most egregious images. However, you can also toggle the partial nudity prevention. And so this is going to detect any bikini, lingerie, or partially clad individuals. So it is going to be a little more sensitive to any of these types of images. I did turn this on, especially for these tests, so that I didn't have to look up actual explicit images where it can just detect whether it's a bikini or something like that. The Canopy app does include location settings, so you can turn on this location awareness, set alerts for different locations. I use other applications for location, so this isn't something that I have enabled on the Canopy app, but it does work just with the phone's location settings. So if your child turns off their location, then it's not going to be able to see that. But this does have location tracking if you want to kind of minimize some of the parental control apps that you're using. Now, while Canopy is really focused on explicit content, you can set other categories to be blocked as well. As you can see here, there are several categories that are included that you can easily just toggle either of these on and off to block those specific categories. So if you don't want them gambling, or if you don't want them on specific social media apps, you can block these categories here. You also have the ability to block or approve specific applications. What's great about this is it's going to give you details in the request on why it may or may not be concerning that you want to allow this app. So you can go ahead and approve or deny access to the app just right here. And you can add specific websites to this parental control app. So if you don't want them to be able to access a site like archive.org or some of the other websites that I have said that you should block for your kids, then you can set those right in here. Because a lot of times, some of these websites, at least the ones that I have recommended, aren't necessarily blocked by normal parental control filters or content filters because they're not necessarily explicit websites. However, you can access explicit material through those websites. So that's why I generally choose to block some of these specific websites. However, on this, you can go ahead and enter any of those here, and it will block those websites. Now, another feature of the Canopy app is to set downtime for the device. So this is going to block out the internet for specific time frames that you enter. And you can enter multiple time frames. So you can enter a bedtime, you can enter when they're at school, you can enter during dinner time. So it's going to shut down access to the phone for those specific time frames. So this really actually rounds out the parental controls to make sure that it's one of the only ones that you would need for the device to cover all of your bases. So as you use the application or as your child uses their device, you will see reporting on what apps and things they are using on their device. Now, this is also going to give you a really good window into what applications your child is using on a regular basis. So if you see an app on here that maybe doesn't make sense, you know, there's some calculator apps that have vault images inside hidden. So you can tell if they're in a specific app like Notes or a calculator on a frequent basis, you might want to dig a little deeper into that and see what exactly they're doing in that app. Because a lot of times kids can find backdoors to the internet, backdoors to inappropriate content. So you want to check and make sure that you know exactly what app your child is using on a regular basis. So the one thing I would really have liked to see with this app is a little bit more on the notification end. I understand why it wasn't maybe not included, but you can get notifications on if they try to remove the application. You can also get notifications on app requests or blocked item requests. However, it's not going to notify you if something gets blocked. So say your child searches for something and it gets blocked, you're not getting a notification that they tried to search for something and it got blocked. I would love to see that included maybe in a future version, but as of right now, if they're getting blocked on things, you're not getting notified of it unless they send you a website request or an app request or a image request. Those requests will come through to you, but otherwise you're not going to be notified. The other thing I would like to see on the Canopy app is the ability to just have multiple devices associated with one user profile. At this point, I just add a device. It's going to basically add another person in the application. I would like to just have the settings for the computer and for the phone all right in the same user profile. And I didn't really see a way to do that through the Canopy app. However, not a big deal. The next user is just the next device. So instead of really users, I would just consider these to be devices instead. Now, in order to add Canopy to a device, for a mobile device, the Canopy app will prompt you to either send the link via text message or via email. Once you send the link, go ahead and open your text message from the device. This is going to be an Android device. So you go ahead and tap on the link and select that you are installing the Kids Protection app. Go ahead and tap download and say download anyway. This is a side-loaded app. So if you have something like Google Family Link already installed, you are going to need to allow the installation of apps from unknown sources, which this is technically an unknown source. Go ahead and tap the download on the Android device and select open. The installation wizard will take you through some things that you'll need to agree to, including that it's going to be a device administrator and allow those applications. So you're going to log in to your Canopy app and select which user it's going to be associated with. Continue with the installation, and then it's going to give you a whole lot of prompts for different areas that you need to allow the app to access in order to do all of the functions that it needs to do. So you're going to hit continue and allow for any of these prompts. Now, when it comes to the Android settings, you're going to need to find Canopy on the list and toggle it on to allow it. So sometimes it might be a little difficult to find here. You're going to go into installed apps and then find Canopy. It's right here at the top, and toggle that on as well. So again, these are all accessing areas of the phone that will give it the ability to do what it needs to do in order to have the Canopy app work properly. So again, there are just more prompts of things that you need to allow and to make sure that it's not going to be uninstalled without your permission. So that's what this toggle is here. It's the removal prevention, and we're going to need to approve the security access to allow that removal prevention to function properly. And we're going to allow these app certificates. And we're almost done here. Again, it's a lot of allowing so that it can function properly. We're going to go ahead and open the kids app, and our installation is complete for the Android device. Similarly, just like I showed on the Android device, you will tap the link for an iOS device that has been texted to the device. You'll go through the prompts just like I showed on the Android solution. There's going to, again, be things that you will need to allow in order for Canopy to function properly. This includes setting up this certificate. You'll need to go into the general settings in the settings application, find the Canopy profile that has been downloaded, and tap install. Once the certificate has been trusted and installed, it will be able to do the things that it needs to do in order to function properly. This is called an MDM profile, which means mobile device management. And this is, again, what is going to allow Canopy to function properly. Once you have allowed the certificate, you will see that the Canopy app has now been installed, and you can approve all of the different notification access and photo access for the application. And once you've approved all of these settings, then it is going to be installed and you will be all set for your iOS device. Now, to install Canopy on a Windows computer, the Canopy app will prompt you to send an email to your child. Once you get that email on your child's device, go ahead and tap on Install Canopy. It will prompt you here, and go ahead and copy this pairing code and download the application. Once it's downloaded, you will need to tap on the executable to install the application. Go ahead and enter the pairing code from the email and tap install. The installation wizard will walk you through the rest of the process, including a setting to make sure that they cannot uninstall the application without your permission. You would just need to check mark that here. Once the installation is complete, it will prompt you to reboot the computer, and you are all set. There's nothing more you need to do. So as you can see, Canopy is a very powerful content filter and explicit content protection for your children's devices. I'm really enjoying it. I think this is one of the best parental control apps that I've come across in recent years. So I am a big fan already. As you can see from my demonstrations and everything, it does work exactly the way it claims to work. I do not accept a lot of sponsored content on this channel because I am very particular about what it is I will endorse, and I will endorse this Canopy app. So thank you again to Canopy for supporting this channel and sponsoring this review. If you have any questions about the Canopy app, please reach out to me. I am at Family Tech on all social media platforms. If you have a question about a specific feature or about how it works, definitely please let me know. Don't forget to subscribe for more content like this. I have a lot of parental control advice on various apps and other settings, so definitely check that out. So please subscribe and like this video, hit that notification bell, and we will see you next time.